Hello everyone, my name is Anuj Jindal and I welcome you to this session wherein I want to talk about what to do in the next 60 days for your RBI prep. Now, if you're thinking that you have not done anything at all concerning RBI examination and you're going to do something miraculous in the next 60 days and clear the examination, it is going to be an uphill task. I'm not saying it's impossible, give up. I am saying it is possible because impossible says I am possible. But at the same time, you have to be ready. You have to pull up your socks and make sure that you're ready to do whatever it takes in the next 60 days. We already created and I already discussed what to do in 75 days when we got to know about the advertisement of RBI examination. And in the first 15 to 20 days, our target has been to cover phase 2 of the examination along with current affairs. Now, I don't want to repeat it, but I will be talking about phase 1 and phase 2 current affairs as well. Give me some time. In the next 5 minutes, we'll be talking about all those things as well. But what to do in the next 60 days to maximize your chances and your probability of success? That is the question right now. We can divide you as a student into different parts. For example, if there is a student, number 1, who is average in phase 1, but wants to revise phase 2 at this point of time because there will be limited time after phase 1. But let's assume that you are a student who is average in phase 1, then what to do? Number 2 would be a student who is very, very below average or very bad at phase 1, especially quant, reasoning and English. What should he do? And number 3 would be a person who is very good at phase 1. What should he do? Let's pick up with the first student who is average in phase 1. Who believes that he can complete phase 1 in the next 50 days. So he has a buffer of about 10 days at this point of time. So what should he be doing? Let's pick up according to his requirements first. So if you are a person who is average in phase 1 or above average in phase 1, you've already done phase 1 quant reasoning and English in the past. You've given some bank exams. You have some idea about quant reasoning English. You feel that in 50 days, you will be able to step up your preparation to a level that you can clear phase 1. Then the next 10 days, I would recommend that you focus on revising or covering. Revising would be a wrong word. I would instead say covering phase 2, management and finance. This is the minimum that you have to do. We've already covered finance in the first 10 days and we are on time to start with management in the next few days, but you can still cover both these two subjects in the next 10 days. At least give them one reading. That will help you a lot between phase 1 and phase 2. Along with this, you also have to cover entire current affairs in the next 10 days, at least as much as possible. Now, what does current affairs consist of? Uske andar aata kya kya hai? Let's try and understand that. It first of all consists of phase 1 spotlight, a minimum of 3 months. It consists of phase 2 RBI 247 and PIB 247. Okay. And finally, it consists of topic based current affairs, TBCA, which includes government schemes, which includes annual surveys, which includes reports, which includes economic survey, budget, census 2011 might be out by the time the examination happens, some data. So whatever annual surveys, decadal surveys, economic survey, reports, various reports released by international organizations or by RBI or the government, all of them come under topic-based current affairs. Okay. Now, phase 2 RBI 247 and PIB 247, minimum of 6 months. Spotlight, minimum of 3 months. This is what comes under current affairs. You have to cover this entire thing before phase 1 itself and you have to start with it now. You cannot postpone this aspect, this part of your syllabus. Okay. So if you're a student who is average or above average in phase 1 quant reasoning English, then the next 10 days can be dedicated to management and finance along with current affairs. Current affairs ke parts maine aapko samjha diye. अब हम क्या क्या करेंगे आपके साथ. राइट नाउ वीक 2 इज गोइंग ऑन एंड द सेम इज गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू एंड यू कैन जस्ट पिक अप वेयर यू लेफ्ट before the notification. So right now spotlight has been done. You can just revise. All of this is available on YouTube. The timetable for motivation, the timetable for management as well as finance is already here. You can just pick up from here because management is starting from 10th May. So from here, management is starting. So in the next 10 days, you can start, you can try and cover management along with me. Along with that, make sure that you're completed, you're done with PIB 247, RBI 247, both of them February 2023. Government schemes PDF 1, a total of 3 PDFs of government schemes have been given to enrolled students. So make sure that you cover that as well. Okay. So you follow this timetable for the next 10 days and from about 22nd of May, you forget about phase 2 syllabus. You keep focusing on current affairs as you have been doing in these next 10 days. And this is the moment that you start with quant, reasoning and English one by one. So first of all, quant will start. We will cover quant in about 10-15 days and then we'll start with reasoning and then we'll move forward. So this is the timetable that will help you cover the entire syllabus of quant, reasoning, English or revise it in the next about 20-25 days. And then you can repeat the cycle and you can supplement your preparation with a lot of mocks. Okay. So this is the timetable that you can follow if you are an average student or above average student in quant, reasoning and English. That I'm focusing upon that again and again and again. Okay. By May end, I'm expecting we'll be done with majority of quant. And from 30th May, we'll be starting with reasoning. Along with that, aapko yahan pe sab bataya gaya hai ki aapko current affairs mein kya kya cover karna hai. Family health survey, periodic labor force survey, ASR report, ICA report, ye sari education ki reports bhi aapko karni hai. Okay. Again, quant will start again after 5th June and then we'll have reasoning again starting from 13th June. Okay. In all this time period, you will see that current affairs goes on. It doesn't stop. It cannot stop because it is the most important aspect of your examination. Okay. Is tarah se aap reasoning chalega 27th, 28th, 29th tak and then we will have marathon starting from 3rd July. Okay, so this is the timetable that you follow exactly as it is, especially if you are a student who has some confidence in quant, reasoning and English and feels that he can use the next about 10 days for phase 2 syllabus preparation. Now let me come to a student who says that I'm very weak in quant, reasoning and English. What to do? For a student who is very, very weak in quant, reasoning and English, it does not make any sense at this point of time to pick up phase 2. Even if you might think, sir, but even if I clear phase 1, it will not help me in phase 2 because I would not have studied anything about phase 2. However, the question here is not what you have not studied. The question here is, how do you make sure that you clear phase 1 given that you're very, very weak in quant, reasoning and English? That's the first ladder. At least first ladder clear karna aapka first objective hone wala hai. So what do you do in that scenario? If you are very weak in quant, reasoning and English or you do not have confidence, you don't know if you're weak or you're not so weak and you're average or above average or good, what do? Instead of spending any energy on phase 2 syllabus, that is management and finance, instead, you put all your energies for the next 10 days in current affairs. Now, listen to me very carefully. So what are you doing? For the next 10 days, you're putting all your energies into current affairs. So from week 2, that is about 9th May, 10th May, to about 20th, 22nd May, you're completely focused on current affairs and you're trying to cover as much current affairs as possible. Now, current affairs ke andar kya kya aata hai? Maine bataya tha aapko. Phase 1 ke andar aayega spotlight at least 3 months. Phase 2 ke andar aayega PIB 247 6 months and RBI 247 6 months and then you have topic based current affairs. Okay. Ye timetable main aapko dal dunga description mein. You can download it and use it. Now all of this you try and cover as much as possible, at least one reading, if possible 2 to 3 readings in the next 10 days. Okay, that will lift a lot of stress from your shoulders in the next 10 days, a lot of burden from your shoulders in the next 10 days. After 22nd May, you completely shift your focus and dedicate about 75% of every day's time towards quant or reasoning and about 25 to 30% of your time towards current affairs, because you would not have completed current affairs, number one. New current affairs will keep on coming, number two. And thirdly, even if you've completed this once, you have to revise it because one reading is not enough. Okay. So let's say you have about 6 hours, 7 hours every day to study. About 5 hours you dedicate, or about 4 hours you dedicate to phase one, quant or reasoning. And about 2 to 3 hours you dedicate to current affairs. That is how you can balance it out starting from 22nd May. And from 22nd May, make sure that you focus and you completely align your studies with the timetable that is mentioned here, so that you're able to maintain consistency. Otherwise, you will study for 3 days and then you will take a break for another 3 days. You will be able to study for, let's say, 12 hours a day for 3 days and then no studies for the next 3 days. And that is very, very harmful. Okay. So from 22nd May, you can start with quant classes, as I will be covering starting from 22nd May. Chetan sir will be covering quant. Spotlight bhi chalta rahega, so you can cover spotlight, government schemes, all these things accordingly, and at the same time when they are being covered by us. Okay. If you already covered them in advance, then it will be a good revision for you as well. So this is what you do if you're a very weak student in quant, reasoning or English. Now let's come to the last category, which is if you're very good at quant, reasoning and English, what do you do? This is where a lot of students end up making a mistake. They think that because they're very good at quant, reasoning, English, so they can dedicate about 20 days or 10 days, the last 10 days or 20 days to QRE and use all this time to prepare for phase two. I would say that is a big mistake that you're doing, because you might end up losing balance. And a lot of students make this mistake and end up not clearing phase one, not clearing, I'm repeating it again, not clearing phase one examination, just because they are overconfident or they feel that they can get through phase one without enough preparation, without enough practice. So what do you do? Now, your concern is correct and your confidence is also fine. I'm not saying don't be confident, but do not allow it to convert into overconfidence. So what do you do? How to manage? How do you balance it out? First of all, for the next 10 days, 10 odd days, you will be focusing upon phase two syllabus. Simultaneously, you will be focusing upon current affairs. Okay. So you will completely align yourself with the way the syllabus is being covered, current affairs is being covered over the next 10 days. You do not have to do anything extra. You do not have to do anything less. If possible, along with management, you can also cover finance once. After 10 days, what do you do? So let's say starting 22nd May, you have about 50 odd days, 22nd June and 9th July. Okay. So aapke paas approximately 50 din hai, 50 se thode se kam din hai, about 47, 48 days you have. You don't want to spend all this time in covering phase one, quant, reasoning and English. You want to be using this time to cover some part of phase two syllabus as well. So what do you do? Now, in this time period, how do you save time is, you do not skip your phase one quant, reasoning and English preparation. However, what you do starting 22nd May is, you start with test series or mocks for phase one, quant, reasoning and English. Instead of ignoring it, you give it enough time, but you do not give it a lot of time, because you don't need to revise quant again. You don't need to cover formulas again. And even if you do in some areas, you can very well do it through test series or through mock tests. So what do you do is, every 3 days, every 4 days, you take one mock of quant, reasoning and English. Along with this, you are covering current affairs. Jo char parts mein maine current affairs bataya aapko. You cannot skip that. You cannot stop that. You have to cover it, and you have to cover it again and again and again. Believe me, students who clear the examination are able to revise, repeat, current affairs up to 10 times. That is the amount of repetition that they're going through. Only then they're able to remember majority of the current affairs. Okay, so that should be a target, 10 times revision and repetition of current affairs. So this is what you have to do additionally, along with one mock test every 3 days. And you can dedicate another 10 days. I'm giving you a bonus of another 10 days from 22nd May to 31st May to covering phase 2 syllabus. If you're already done with phase 2 finance and management, you can use the ESI marathon classes to cover phase 2 ESI syllabus. If you're already done with finance and management but want to repeat it again, you can do that as well. If you want to write tests, you can do that as well. You can do whatever you want in these next 10 days to ace and to refine your preparation of phase 2 syllabus. The problem with this strategy is that you have 3 things to do. So you have to be very smart and you have to control your anxiety. Number one, you are doing test series, one test series of phase 1 every 3 days. Number two, every day you're covering current affairs. And number three, every day you are covering finance or management or ESI, that is syllabus or static part of phase 2. Okay, so these are the 3 things that you have to do. The good thing, the good part here is that you do not have to write test series every day. You have to write it only, let's say, once in 3 days or once in 4 days. So that writing of test series is not going to be a regular phenomena. Therefore, in short, you're doing 2 tasks every day, but once every 3rd day, you're focusing more on this test series. Okay. This way, you will be completely synced with this timetable as well, starting from 1 second, 22nd May. So 22nd May pe aa jate hain ek baar. So from 22nd May, you can keep covering the current affairs that has been mentioned here. Jaise yahan pe diya hua hai, topics of week 4 mein, jo yahan pe cover hona hai, plus you have to cover PIB 247 and RBI 247 of April. You have to cover government schemes PDF 2. If you've already covered them, revise them. Okay. So you're covering current affairs of phase 1 and phase 2 in this week. Plus, instead of you, the only thing that you're missing out on is, instead of doing quant class 1 and covering these topics, you're taking a comprehensive test once every 3 days. So you can just rely on this test, phase 1 test 1, phase 1 test 2. So on the same dates, you can take one test for yourself, and on the remaining days, you can instead replace it with phase 2 syllabus. So that is the only change that you're making in your preparation, and that too only for 10 days. After 10 days, you dedicate about 40 days completely to phase 1, because I have seen a lot of students failing phase 1 in that overconfidence that they can cover phase 1. They're very good at quant reasoning English. They've given CAT and they were able to score well. Their percentile was very good. So they do not need to spend that much time. If you feel that way, then spend more time on current affairs, because current affairs is going to help you a lot in phase 2. But do not give a lot of time to phase 2 syllabus after 1st June. That will be a recipe for disaster for you. Okay, because your mind takes time to get adjusted to what the target is. If you keep it confused, if for the next 10 days again you're covering phase 2 syllabus only, it might not be able to adjust as much. Okay, so that is all. This is the timetable for the next 60 days. I've divided your categories as student into 3 parts, and I'm very, very sure this categorization classification will help you identify yourself as one of these 3 classifications and then prepare accordingly. If you have any doubts, if you want to discuss with me about anything at all related to examination, then you can do that in the comment section below. You can also reach out to me. The number is available in the description. Let me write it down here as well. 9999466225. And you can also reach out to me via email info@anujindal.in. And if you're not aware about the website, the name of the website is www.anujjindal.in. Okay, so this is all for today. I wish you all the best. I'm very, very certain that you're going to do very well in the upcoming examination and you're going to do wonders. Just keep studying hard. Do not get anxious. Whenever you get anxious, get back to your books, get back to your studies, because that is the only way of clearing you, of getting you through this journey successfully. There is no other way. There is no shortcut. There is no magic wand that can get you through the examination. It's only studies. It's only hard work. It's only dedication with which you can do it. Okay. All the best, guys. I'll see you very soon again. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.